Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to discuss about on-page SEO. So here you will be learning how to optimize your website for search engine. So let's get started. First, on-page SEO. So what do you mean by this on-page SEO? So on-page SEO is a technique that performed within the website for search engines and users. Okay, so whatever the activities we perform is just to improve the rankings of the website and to make Google understand what our website is all about. This is simply called as on-page SEO. Everything we are doing within our site. Okay, so now how Google actually shows up any website on top? What is the process runs behind the Google is that first of all, Google show up any website on top based on the relevancy. The most basic signal that information is relevant is when a web page contains the same keywords as your search query. So if those keywords appear on the page or else if they appear in the headings or body of the text, the information is more likely to be what relevancy means. Okay, now what do you mean by a keyword? So here I'm telling you that Google find out more relevancy when someone uses the keyword many times. So what do you mean by keyword? Yeah. Keyword is any word or phrase that user types into the search engine, like, you know, Google or else Yahoo, anything, Bing or whatever it might be, to find out certain information on the internet. That is just called as. So now if I search with anything, let me tell you, online digital marketing training. So I search with this word and this is a phrase, it might be. So now this online digital marketing training will be the keyword. So this is the word I am using to search in the search engine called Google to find out the certain information. So now this is what keyword. So if this keyword is used by a website owner or many times in the web page, then Google automatically choose that as a more relevant. That is how Google works. Okay, that is how Google show up the website. Okay, so now you find out that here keyword plays a vital role. Okay, so in order to step further, we need to do a proper keyword research first of all. In order to optimize our on-site, we need to do a proper keyword research. How can I do a keyword research? What is the use of this keyword research? Let me tell you first of all. So keyword research means simply finding out your focusing keyword of your web page. Let's say you are trying to write a blog on page SEO. Okay. So this is your topic and you need to write about this topic. So your responsibility is to find out the keyword for this topic. Okay, that you can find out when you do a proper keyword research only. Okay, so how we can do this proper keyword research, let us see now. So first and most thing is to find out your keyword, know your niche first. Know your niche. So on which topic you are writing about. Okay, and think from the user's perspective also. So what can be their possible keyword? How people can search for these kinds of information? So think from their perspective even and find out the keywords. Okay, so let's say I want to write a topic on page SEO. So now I'll be thinking from user's perspective. So they can search for a keyword called on page SEO. What is on page SEO? On site SEO. So they might search for these kinds of keywords even. Next, how to do on-page SEO. Okay. So here I am trying to list out a few keywords from the user's perspective. This is just simply called as brainstorming. Okay, so now I have done brainstorming. So I found out the keywords from the user's perspective. Then, so not only that you can do, you can even find out the keyword ideas and their volume even, which is the best keyword suitable for you also. You can find out through the tools. So we have a few tools like keyword planner, keyword frequency. Now I use a href. So this is a tool which where I can find a number of keyword ideas. So now let me open this Ahrefs and show you how I will be finding the keywords for my niche. So let me open Ahrefs. So here it is. So keyword explorer. I want to explore the keywords. Page SEO. So this is what my keyword be. So I'll be searching with these keywords. So it is showing me the keyword difficulty also. So it's the keyword difficulty is 74 and it is very super hard to reach out on top for this keyword. And I have some similar terms also: on page SEO, on page SEO, on page SEO checklist, SEO checker, SEO check services. What is on page SEO? So what is on page SEO? What are the most important factors to review? How to do? So these are the some similar terms you can find out. And if I go with the all keyword ideas, I can see what all the keywords, then pages optimize, the words it is showing. So for our page, it is having a 246,000 volume, pages optimize, search engines list, Google blog, perfectly on site optimized. So here it is showing you the exact word and their value maybe. So now you can use which is best for you. Okay, people search engines factors of Google guide, page one, search engine list. So here find out the keyword which is best suitable for your business and use that keyword. Okay, let me use this on page SEO. It is very fine for me. Okay, on page SEO, this is my focusing keyword. So now after doing this keyword research, I found my focusing keyword. Then what I have to do with this keyword? So not only finding a keyword, it's not enough, right? So you have to do something with that keyword. What I have to do is, after finding the right keyword, you have to put that right keyword in a right place. So what do I mean right place in the sense? Yes. So from here, your on-page SEO starts. So first thing is, optimize your content. Optimize your content with keywords. Okay. The next thing is blog post title in H1 heading. Blog post title in H1 tag. Okay, so this is first you have to optimize your content. Next you need to write title in the H1 heading, then use subheadings, wrap subheadings in H2 tags. The next is optimize your file name. Or we can call them as a URL even. Next, optimize your titles and description tags. Next, image optimization. Next is interlinking. Internal linking. Then bolds and italics. What I am trying to say here is, you have to use your keyword in all these important places which I have mentioned now. So Here in the content, you have to use your keyword in the blog post title and then subheadings. So in all these important places, you have to use your keyword. Why? Because so Google will concentrate more on these places. Okay, so that's the reason we are trying to concentrate on these important places. First of all, so what is this? First, optimize your content with keyword. Let us see. So in order to do all those things, I need to get into the dashboard of the website, right? So where we are supposed to do all those things? Within the website itself, right? So now let us get into the website. Let me get into my website, dizzycodes.in. Right, so let me write some posts. So there you can see all these options. Now I'm going to show you all these important places, where these important places present within your site. So now my aim is that now I'm ready with my topic. So now that I want to write a topic on page SEO. Okay, so now I'm trying to write a blog on page SEO. So you have to click on post and start writing a blog. Okay, first thing is optimize your content for SEO. So it's a time to start optimizing your content. Now I'm going to show you how to keyword optimize every page on your site. Use your focusing keyword in all the important places. Okay, so first thing is, let me write something like, so here you can see a title option. Add the title. Okay. So here the second one is blog post title in H1 tag. The once you open the post, you can see a starting option is add title. So make sure that your title is in H1's heading. So as we are using the WordPress, right? So by default with the WordPress, our title will be a H1 heading only. Make sure that your title will be in a H1 heading only. It makes, so why? Because it makes Google understand the structure of the page. Okay. Now, if I write a title in my H1 heading, yes, users and then Google understand what I'm trying to show up with the complete this page. Okay, let me and try to include your keyword in the title H1 tag. On page. Full guide step by step. So here I'm trying to write my title. This is my title. Okay. So from here you can start writing a blog, and here you can start using your focusing keyword. Let me start writing something here on page SEO. Now what I'm trying to do is, you have to use your focusing keyword once in 100 to 150 words. I'm trying use once in 100 to 150 words, because from starting, why I'm trying to say to use your keyword from starting 100 to 150, because from Google perspective, Google gives more weight on terms that show up early in your page. Okay, so hope you understand this. I'm trying to use this keyword early in 100 to 150 words. Okay, I tried using this. Let me write some content now. So this is how I write some content in such a way you start writing a content in your website. Okay, then what I have to do? The next thing is, so here optimize your content with the keyword in such a way, start writing a blog and use the keyword wherever necessary. I'm not saying that stuff the keywords. I'm saying that use the keywords wherever it required naturally. Don't use wantedly. So if you use a wantedly everywhere for each and every 10 words, then it would be like a stuffing keywords. Never ever do that, because keyword stuffing would be like a black hat SEO. If you do is black hat, if you perform black hat SEO, what happens? So Google will penalize your website. Okay, never ever practice it. So you have to use the keywords, but naturally wherever it required. So in such a way, use the keywords. Then blog post title in H1 heading. So I tried to put my title in a H1, then wrap subheadings in H2 heading. So you can use a subheadings as a H2 heading. So whatever you want to put as a subheading, use them as a H2 heading. Okay, right. This is not about keyword stuffing. Definitely I'm saying do remember that. So and to include your target keywords in at least one of your subheading. Let's say if you're writing if you're having 5 subheadings, so make sure that you have at least one focusing keyword in one of the 5 subheadings. So let me write some. Optimize your content. I'm going to make it as a subheading. H2 heading. Okay. Website, use your focusing keyword once in 100 to 150. So why I'm trying to use these keywords from once in 100 to 150 words means, because so I'm trying to make Google understand that what my topic is all about. So when my website has to trigger, so if Google find out my keywords, so what happens? Google will think that yes, this blog is all about the keyword called on-page SEO. So in such a way, Google will show up your website for a particular keyword if you use that particular keyword only. Okay, so this is how you use the subheadings. Now I use a subheading called optimize your content. So in such a way, use the subheadings in H2 heading and make sure that you have a one keyword at least. Okay. So and then next is optimizing your URL, optimizing your file name. Okay. Now you can see that on page SEO. So what is my file name is? So here you can see my file name. File name is the URL of the blog post. So dizzycourse.in ?p equals to 142. So it's a very bad URL. It does not have any meaning, right? So does it have any meaning? No. So if someone sees that URL, so even Google can't understand what is this URL all about. So how can it displays in SERP? So it would be, again, we are putting the Google into confusion again. Only because of this URL. Okay, so make sure that your URL is also very very perfect. Make sure that your URL should be very short and try to include the keyword in every URL. Okay, so how can you edit any website URL, any blog URL? Let me show you. So here you have an option called settings. Under settings you have an option called permalinks. Can you see this? So this is a permalink you have to click. So you have to check this post name. So whether it is a post name or plain day and name. So you have to check which option we have chosen. So it's fine. We are into a post name. Just save changes. So go back to our post and see, edit and see the URL, how the URL is. Now can you see, this is my post blog post URL, dizzycourse.in on page SEO full guide step by step. Okay, so by this, yes, I'm making Google understand that yes, this blog is all about on page SEO. So try to make it as a short. So no problem if it is a long tail keyword also, nothing will happen. So if you use this long tail keyword, better, because your blog will supposed to appear on top when someone searches with long tail keyword even. So better to go with this, no problem. Okay, so this is how you optimize the URL on file name, I can say. The next thing is title and description tags. Optimize the title and description. What do you mean by title and description tags? So I have already seen the title. Then what is the title and description tags? Yes, so you can see here, whenever you search with any keyword, you get some results over here, right? So now this is an organic result. Okay, now you can see the learndigital.withgoogle.com. This is a file name. Till now, whatever we optimized the URL, so that will appear here in a SERP. So this complete page is called SERP. So there your URL file name will appears on top. Okay, so the blue color, the text in the blue color, you can see this is the title tag of the particular block. Okay, and remaining whatever you can see the content, this is called description tag. Simply the title and description tags are the things that appears in a SERP when someone searches with a particular keyword. Okay, so you make sure that you have a titles and description tags for each and every blog, for each and every page you have in your website. So it's very important because it strengthens your SEO. Okay, use modifiers like best, guide and checklist, you know, called first. Use that kinds of things in your titles and description. Okay, right. So now you came to know what is meant by a title and description tag. Okay, so when someone click this, they will see a blog, or they will go to a website. So there they can see the some content where they have written in their website itself. Okay, now it's time to write one title and description tag for my blog. Okay, so this is our blog, right? I need to write one title and description tag for this blog. So how do we write title and description tag is, so do remember that, so by default you can't write any title and description tags for any blog. So with the WordPress, you need to install a plugin, that is a Yoast SEO plugin, or else you can install all-in-one SEO plugin, any one of these. If you install any one of these plugin, then only you will be having an option to write title and description tags, otherwise no. Okay, so I have already installed this Yoast SEO plugin into my website so that I can write. So can you see here, snippet review, so edit snippet. So here you have an option to write a title and description. Okay, can you see here, SEO title and meta description. Okay, right. So now let me write some title which has to be very attractive when people by seeing that only people has to click, right? Yeah, let me on page SEO guide step by step. Your business, can you see here, now my strength is green color. If it is in a green color, then your SEO title is good one. Okay, make sure that your titles and your meta descriptions are in a green color. Okay, slug. So this is what the URL, how it appears in the SERP. Okay, now it's fine. This is the meta description. So use unique meta description. Adding meta description, meta text to each of your pages is always a good practice. I am saying again, also include your keyword once in your description. Okay, so I'm trying to include my keyword once in my description. You're looking for improving your site rankings, definitely it's your responsibility to know how to optimize your you will learn step by step. So it is exceeding. Let me make it like this. Okay, fine. Now my SEO title and SEO description is very fine because I tried using the my on-page SEO keyword. So let me use this. So I tried using the keyword in my meta description and meta title as well. That's so fine. Okay. So yeah, let me update it again. Then next, what is the next thing? Title and description, tags done, image optimization. What is this image optimization means? So it's very natural that we use images while writing a content. So we use images in the websites, right? So without images, no website will be there. So if we want to attract the people, the visual thing will do more of, right? So if I want to use images, so Google can't read the images. Okay. So if I want me Google to read images and Google to find out what my image is all about, I have to optimize my image even. So how do you optimize your image means, first of all, you have to select the image. Okay, so here I'll be selecting the featured image. Let me select. Okay, let me choose this image. So optimizing means you have to make Google to understand. That is called writing alternative text for the image. Okay, so now here, once you select the image, here you have an option to write alternative text. That means alternative text for the image. So try to use your keyword in this alternative text bar, because yes, if I use on page SEO, so that is my keyword. So what happens? I'm trying to make Google understand that this image is all about on-page SEO, so that my SEO will become more and more stronger. So it become better and better. So use a title even. So definitely, whenever you use the images, make sure that you give the alternative text for the image. Set a future. This is what image optimization, definitely it is very responsibility, is your responsibility to optimize the images even. The next thing is internal linking. So what does it mean, internal linking? Yes, so internal linking also plays a vital role, because yes, we need to interlink to one of our pages in our websites. Okay, that is also Google will treat. So how we can link back to any other page in our website? Let us see now. Okay, let me see this. I want to give a link back to one of my pages. what is off-page optimization. So for this blog, I will be giving a link back. Okay, what I have to do is copy the complete URL, edit, and then so here you can write. Wants to know more about off-page SEO. More about off-page SEO. So I'll be giving a link back to off-page SEO blog of my website. So just select the complete word, and then can you see here option called link option? Just click this and enter the URL, then apply it. Now it will be a clickable text. This is called internal links. Try to give the internal links in your blog. It is very good for the SEO. Google will read that even. Okay, so this is how you give a links. Then next, bolds and italics. So what is this bolds and italics? Yes, so make sure that you make the few words into bolds and italics, because Google will read that bolds and italics. Google will crawl your bolds and italics even. Okay, so try to make some bolds and italics even. Now how to make anything bold and italic is, so let me show you. Can you see here on page SEO? So here I just wants to make it as a bold. Select it and you can see option called B. Just click this and you can make it as a bold. So try to make your keywords, no, I'm not saying that all your keywords, at least one or two, three keywords bold. Make it bold. Okay. So okay, I can make it like content, make it italic. So in such a way, I can make anything bold and anything italic. So done, right? So we optimized our content with the keyword. That means we try to use the keyword, our focusing keyword, in all important places wherever it is required. So what are those important places? Is blog post title. So in H1 heading I used my keyword, in subheadings also I used my keyword, then in the file name URL I used my keyword, then titles and description also, yes. Of course, image optimization in the alternative text also I gave my URL. Then internal linking back to other page in your website, and then bold italics. Okay, so finally I can say that, so make sure that your content should be from the searcher intent. Okay, so it has to be very, very useful for the searcher who is searching for a particular keyword. So don't run out for rankings only. So you have to be more informational. So give some information for the user. Definitely Google is going to make your website on top. So concentrate more on content. So one more thing is, never ever copy the content. So don't raise the duplicate content. Okay, so write your own content, genuine content. And one more thing, it has to be very unique even. Okay, write something unique and different which other website, other blogs does not have. Then it would be like more impact on your website. Okay, so these are the techniques you need to follow while you optimize your on-site. Okay, so I hope you understand this topic. So if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. Okay, thanks, bye.